Hi everyone, welcome to Shambhala Farm. My name is Craig Hubbard. Today we're going to grow some seedlings. What we're going to need is our seeds, a tray, our growing medium, a watering can, and a place to put our seedling tray. So we're using our greenhouse up here. Let's get started. Today we're going to be growing Tuscan kale, otherwise known as blue kale, Scotch kale, a popular kale at our farmers markets, and we get asked a lot about how to grow kale. Growing kale is not too much different in terms of germinating in the seeds as it is to germinate silver beet or other varieties. First up, we need our tray. So we're using one of these 198 cell trays. We've got a sieve. A sieve is really handy for getting rid of all the big material that we don't want in our seedling mix. Now, we can go and buy our seedling mix from the nursery, but I do find that that's often got a lot of bark chip in it. It's too coarse, so it needs to be a lot finer. We make our own here at the farm, and in another video we'll actually show you how to make your own and give you a recipe for that. But we've got some made already in here, and we'll just finish sifting that off. So in here we've got compost and worm castings straight out of the worm farm, so we'll just sift the big material out of there. The great thing about a sieve, and you can get these at a produce store, is you could get some really nice compost from the garden, some nice soil, and just sieve out any of the large material. Then we'll bring our tray over. I'm just going to fill it. It's good to do this over a wheelbarrow. Nice big pile, and just pushing that through over the whole tray. You don't want to pack it down either. We're just smoothing it off. We're not actually compressing it in. Filling up all the holes. Now this mix is got a mix of compost, sifted, a little worm, he can go back into the compost, and it's also a mix of perlite and vermiculite, which are natural forming light rock, which means that this mix is particularly light. It doesn't get too heavy, in that it won't make the seedlings or seeds too damp. And it's very light to push up through, so very easily to sprout in. Okay, so we've got our tray filled. I'm just going to use a stick today as our dibbler. Dibble meaning putting a little groove into this for our seeds to fall into. And we only want to go down 5 mil for the kale seeds, just so it sits a few mil under the surface. So we have our tray all dibbled out. Now we need our seeds. We've got a great place up here called Green Harvest that we get our seeds from. I'm going to just use the folded paper method. So you can fold an envelope, nice sharp line across the bottom. Seeds are in there. And then we're just going to tap them until they fall down. And we might get a couple in there, that's fine. As long as we get at least one, and in these little seeds, they're quite small, we'll probably get a few in there, and that's all right, because when they sprout, we'll be able to thin them out. So we'll just move up the tray. Okay, so we've got our seed in our holes. We'll put our seed back in its clean, dry packet. Okay, get that away. Our seeds are in, and now we're going to cover it up with the same material, a really light material. We want to make sure that this top layer is the finest, and you might even have a finer sieve. So we've got really fine material here, and another light cover on top there. and we'll just gently press that over, and that covers the seeds up. So the next thing we need to do is just give them a water. I always start the watering off to the side, but then we'll come through and we want to come all the way off the edge to get them all nice and even. Too much water in one spot could expose our seeds and prevent germination. So just a little bit of water twice a day is perfect. That's it. That's now been activated. It's got its nutrient already because it's got its compost in there. And then the magic of nature really begins. The next 24 to 48 hours, the seed germinates and then sprouts above the surface. And as long as we keep the conditions right for that seed in that season, then we'll have a strong seedling to plant out in the fields or the gardens within 3 to 4 weeks. That is our video for how to start off your kale and how to start off your seedlings. I hope you've enjoyed watching this. Please share and like this and subscribe to the channel. And if you'd like to see more, please comment in the comments below. Thank you very much. My name is Craig Hubbard from Shambhala Farm.